Good day, students. Welcome to Mathgotserved.com. This is part one of our series on TI89 skills to enable you to be successful in calculus. In this installment, we're going to be going over how to use the TI89 calculator to find the derivative of a function. Do visit our website at Mathgotserved.com or click on the link below to gain access to all the tutorials that we have to help you gain full mastery of the use of TI-89 calculator in your calculus class. All right, let's take a look at the first example. So let's say you are to find the derivative of the following. So for problem one, if y is equal to x to the second power, find y prime, okay? So this notation right here, prime, this is the Lagrange notation for derivatives, but the notation that the calculator uses on the home screen for differentiation is the Leibniz notation, okay? So what we're going to do is find the derivative manually first and then go over how to do it with a calculator, okay? So we're going to use the power rule here. If y is equal to x squared, then y prime using the power rule is going to be 2x, okay? Now, if you want to carry out the same procedure using the Leibniz notation, if you have y is equal to x squared, you basically differentiate both sides. You find d dx of both sides of the equation, all right? Derivative with respect to x of y is equal to the derivative with respect to x, d dx of x squared, all right? And then you end up with dy dx equals 2x dx dx, which is just 1, okay? So we get the same answer. This is the Lagrange notation, and this is the Leibniz notation, okay? But they mean the same thing. Now, let's go ahead and go over how to find the derivative using the calculator. So if you want to take the derivative from the home screen, you're going to use the F3 menu, okay? So you press an F3, and you see a whole bunch of functions you can carry out using the calculator for calculus. You have derivative, integral, limit, and other cool things that you can do. We're going to be making use of option number one in the calculus menu, which is under the F3 tab of the home screen. Okay, so you press F3, and then you have differentiate, you select that. You see that D right there means differentiate. Okay, now if you forget what the syntax is, there's an easy trick you can use to remember the syntax for any function. What you do is you go to the catalog and look for that function, and underneath here you will see what the syntax is for that function. Alright, so how about we go ahead and determine what the syntax is for the derivative function. Alright, we'll have the calculator tell us what it is. So press the catalog button, and then let's scroll down to D. I can scroll down using the arrow, or I can just jump to D by pressing the alphabet. Okay, so let's just press D. Takes us to D. Scroll down to D of, which means differentiate. Now you see down here, it tells you the syntax for using the derivative function. What is the syntax? After D parenthesis, you enter the expression, comma, the variable you're differentiating with respect to, and the order of differentiation. Are you looking for the first derivative, second, third, fourth? You enter that last, okay? All right, so let's keep that in mind. So let's even write down what the syntax is so we can be consistent. So the syntax is you have D, that's a function, and then you have the expression. And then next is the variable. And then the last thing to enter is the order. All right. The order. Okay, so there goes the syntax. So sometimes you might forget the syntax for a particular function using the TI89. So it's very helpful to go to the catalog, and the calculator will basically remind you of what the syntax is. So let's go ahead and take advantage of this to find the derivative of x squared. So we can escape. So d, enter the expression first. The expression is x squared. So x raised to the second power, comma, the variable of differentiation is, we're differentiating with respect to x. So we have x, comma, and then what's the order of the derivative here? Using the Lagrange notation, the number of primes tells you the order, okay? If you have one prime notation, that's the first derivative. If you have two, that's the second derivative, and on, okay? We have one prime notation here. That means we're looking for the first derivative. Now, when you're using the d parenthesis function in your calculator, the default order is 1, okay? So if I do not specify an order here, I just close this argument and press enter, it computes the first derivative. See, d dx, that's the Leibniz notation of x squared, is 2x dx dx, which cancels out. So 2x is your final answer. Let's go ahead and specify the order here. What is the order of this derivative? 1 prime is the first derivative, okay? So, comma 1, enter. Now you notice it tells us the order of the derivative we computed here, the first derivative of x squared, which is 2x. All right, so whenever you're looking for the first derivative, there's no need to enter the order since the default order is 1. Now let's go ahead and try another example. What if we're given a velocity function? If v of t is equal to 3t squared plus 2t plus 5, find a of t. Okay? So what's the relationship between velocity and acceleration? We know that the instantaneous rate of change of the velocity is the acceleration, or the derivative of velocity is the acceleration, okay? So what this problem is asking us to do is to find the derivative of the velocity. Okay, so let's go ahead and write down the relationship between these two functions. A of t is equal to the derivative with respect to time, that's the independent variable here, of the velocity, all right? So in this situation, we're going to be looking for d dt of 3t squared plus 2t plus 5. Now you notice how our independent variable is t and we were using x's before. Now how can we reflect this in the calculator? We're going to keep that in mind. Let's compute this derivative manually first, and then we'll use the calculator to do it, okay? So applying the power rule for each term, doing term by term differentiation, we have 6t plus 2 as our acceleration function, okay? Now let's go ahead and do that to the calculator. I'm going to go back to the F3 menu, number 1, which is the differentiation function, and then we're going to enter the function, the velocity function, 3t raised to the second power, comma, 2t, plus 2t, plus 5, comma. Now, remember the syntax we used for the first problem? Enter the expression and then the variable. Now what's the variable here? The variable is the independent variable that we're differentiating with respect to. So that is t. Okay? And then what order are we looking for? We're looking for the first derivative, so we don't have to put the order. You can put that in there if you want, but the default order, as indicated earlier, is 1. Okay, so press enter, and you can see that our answer is correct, 60 plus 2. All right, let's consider an example concerning higher order derivatives. So what if we have if y were equal to 3 e to the 3x, you're to find d square y dx square. Okay, d square y dx squared, that's what we are to find here. Now, how do we find d square y dx square? This is the Leibniz notation for higher order derivatives. So, because we have the 2s here, that indicates that we're looking for the second derivative. So what we're going to do is find the second derivative manually first, and then use the calculator to compute the second derivative, okay? Okay, so let's do the first derivative. We're going to find d dx of y, which is d dx of 3e to the 3x. Okay, so we have dy dx equals, we remember the derivative of e to the 3x, right? So the derivative of e to the x is simply e to the x. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that here. We can factor out the 3. The derivative of e to the 3x, using the chain rule, we differentiate the outer function, e to the 3x evaluated at the inner, which is 3x, times the derivative of the inner function 3x, which is 3. So our first derivative, dy dx, is 9e to the 3x. Now we're going to go ahead and find the second derivative. We're going to be looking for d dx of dy dx, which is equal to d dx of 9e to the 3x. So let's go ahead and find out what d square y dx square is. So we have factor out the 9. If you differentiate e to the 3x using the chain rule, as we did here, we'll have e to the 3x, the derivative of the outside function evaluated at the inside, times the derivative of the inner function, which is just 3. And then when you multiply it out, you have 27e to the 3x as our second derivative. Okay, now let's use our calculator to compute that. Using the syntax that we went over earlier, you have d of the expression. The expression here is 3e to the 3x. The variable that we are differentiating with respect to is x, and then the order is 2 in this case. Okay, press enter, 27e to the 3x. So there goes the procedure for finding higher order derivatives. All right, let's take a look at the last example. Here we're going to be going over how to find the derivative at a particular point. Okay, so question number 4, find f prime of 3 where f of x is equal to 2x squared plus 3x. Okay, let's go ahead and find this by hand first, do this manually. And then we will do this with a calculator, okay? So when you're evaluating the derivative at a point, there are two steps to it. You first of all find f prime of x, the derivative. Let's put this down steps. You find the derivative, and then you find the derivative evaluated at a specified point. Okay, let's go ahead and do it. First thing we want to find is f prime of x. So using the Lagrange notation, f prime of x is going to be 4x plus 3. Okay, now we found the derivative. We want to evaluate the derivative at this particular point, namely x equals 3. So f prime of 3 simply means you plug in 3 into your derivative function. Okay, so let's go ahead and plug that in. We have 4 times 3 plus 2, I mean plus 3, that's 12 plus 3, which is 15. Okay, so that's how you compute it manually. Now let's use a calculator. So we're going to use the syntax we went over earlier. The derivative of the expression 2x to the second power plus 3x. Variable that we're differentiating with respect to is x. We don't need the order here. Now this would just yield, we generate the derivative function for x plus 3. But we want to save time. We want to know what the derivative at a particular point is. So that's not too difficult to do. So the shortcut here is you click on this bar. This bar means you're evaluating whatever function to the left of the bar is at what value. So we are evaluating the derivative at x equals 3. Okay, so that's basically how you do it. So press enter and you get 15. So this expression, this command right here is carrying out two operations simultaneously. It's differentiating and then evaluating the result at a particular point. So your final answer is 15. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this presentation. Really appreciate it. Feel free to subscribe to our channel for updates to other cool tutorials such as this. And please post a comment in the comment section to let us know what you think about this presentation. More clips can be found on mathgotserved.com under AP Calculus. Thanks again for watching and have a wonderful day.